give us direction from above. We need a word from the Lord, a word from the
Lord. Real good for just us to be here. We want to thank you for being in the house of the Lord. For him and his whole family, and anything that we can do as a church, we want to stand behind him. Amen.
Amen.
We pray a special prayer for him and his whole family. Amen. This month, we are starting a new series. We started it a little late. This subject matter is not unfamiliar to us as a church, and we're going to be talking about this month's solitude with the Savior. Solitude with the Savior. And we're going to be standing on Luke chapter 5 verses 15 through 16 this whole month. We're going to do a lesson on that tonight, but as the Reverend pushed the button, we want to go ahead and let you know that this is the year with God. This year has been designated a year with God. This year we'll be using the book of the same name by Richard J. Foster to walk us through this year of devotion with God. A year with God helps the Christians to focus on the basic disciplines of the Christian faith. June is designated Solitude Month. Solitude Month. And this is what Richard Foster has to say, that the gospel tells us that Jesus' very public ministry was interspersed with periods of solitude during which he, either completely by himself or with the disciples, left the crowds behind to pray. These times of solitude appear to nourish Jesus for those times when he was in the public eye. And dare I say that especially for those of us who are in the ministry, pastors and deacons, Sunday school teachers, those who serve in the arena of ministry where they pull themselves out, that solitude is a very important concept to come to terms with. And we're going to see that beginning tonight, but all year we've been asking and encouraging you, if you are able, to get this book, which is entitled A Year with God, Living Out the Spiritual Disciplines. And in this book, this month, we will be reading days 186 through 205 in the book. And if you don't have the book in your lessons tonight, I have the scriptures that are in the book where you can daily examine the scriptures that deal with solitude. And it's in your handouts right up under the thesis for tonight. And also, these sections deal with solitude. And also, we will be reading from Celebration of Discipline, the other book, if you've got that book. That's those of you who want to go to level 4. Level 1, again, is just to show up. Level 2 is to get the book. And level 3 is to actually read the book. And then level 4 is to get this other book, Celebrations of Discipline, which is the basis. That book is the basis of this book. A classic in the Christian faith. So if you can pick up both books. And in that book, we're reading pages 96 through 109. And of course, that deals with solitude as well. But the sermon series that we're going to be preaching this month again is Solitude with the Savior. Solitude with the Savior. And this is where we get our theme for this year. Bethlehem!
Live it out!
We're trying to live out the basic disciplines of the faith. And again, this month is the month of solitude. Learning to steal away and spend time with God. Amen. But tonight we're going to look at a lesson entitled, How to Stay Spiritually Renewed. How to Stay Spiritually Renewed. And we're going to be looking at the text that we talked about before, which is the foundation text for the series, Luke chapter 5, verses 15 through 16. Now, let's read this out loud at the same time on three. One, two, three.
Yet the news about him spread all the more, so that crowds of people came to hear him and to be healed of their sickness. But Jesus often withdrew to lonely places and prayed.
Amen. Thank you. I want to read it again. Yet the news about him spread all the more, so the crowd of people came to hear him and to be healed of their sicknesses. But Jesus often withdrew to lonely places and prayed. My thesis tonight is that Christians should withdraw to solitary places to pray. Christians should withdraw to solitary places to pray if they want to know how to stay spiritually renewed. If they want to know how to stay spiritually renewed, you have to learn to withdraw to solitary places. We're going to look at 3 points tonight. We're going to talk about the power that was at work in Jesus' life. We're going to talk about the places where Jesus hung out. And then we're going to talk about the prayer that Jesus prayed to stay spiritually renewed. I think about prayer in the same way that I think of a prize fighter. A prize fighter, when he gets ready to seriously train, they generally will leave the city behind and they'll have a training center somewhere up in the mountains or somewhere in a isolated place, and there they will train for the fight. If you ever saw the movie Muhammad Ali, you'll see that that's what he did. As he left the cities, he left his family, he left his wife, he left everybody behind, and he went to a desert place or a isolated place and trained. If you're familiar with the movie Rocky, I think in Rocky 3, he left the glamorous gym and he began to go in a desert place to train. In a desert, deserted place, I couldn't help but to think, for the Christian, that's what we have to do if we're going to stay spiritually renewed. We've got to still
the calm on the sea, but what we need is a special word.